Right, hello driver, your task this afternoon is to pick up passengers here at Speenbridge and then stop at Fort William, where you'll run around your train and then drive a non-stopping service to Glenfinnan. Open the doors and let your passengers board. Your departure time is 12:04 PM sharp. Good luck and enjoy the scenery. I'll give it time to finish loading the scenery. Is this a green 50? Yes, this is a green J50. It'll speed up in a minute once it's finished loading all the scenery in. There you go, it's already a little bit better. I love this little loco. I don't know why, but I've always liked the little J50. Stargate King, when you make your request, if you could suggest what day or days would be good to play it, and then I will... make sure I don't play it on any of the other ones. That one? Yeah, that's a B, I think. Oh look, it's a black 5. JPD, is it a short stream tonight? I don't think so. We've got, had a half an hour, then an hour, and then an hour and a half. So it'll be probably about three hours, which is sort of normalish length, really. Of course, right at the end of this little bit, I decide now's a great time to take a screenshot. You know what this is, don't you? It's a pillar of a community. You know what, I'm going to go on Facebook and like that post. Yeah, okay. So I'm not going to start that again. Right away. Where's the rail driver cat? The rail driver isn't running tonight because I haven't got a Got a flashing blue light, which if memory serves means I can go. This livery comes with the J50 lid catcher. Solid blue light now. Mark 1 coaches with West Highland Line, yeah. Well, apparently flashing blue light usually means they should stop. No. I thought it was Oh, I don't know. I can't remember, I haven't got the manual up. I couldn't see any reason why I shouldn't stop. The train's already gone. Right, this is us running down Spring Bridge. Appears to be clear all the way. Oh dear, I'm already on. Sounds nice too. Coal going in, we appear to be losing boiler pressure. Cheers, Adama. Even Stevens, you should make a couple of scenarios for Steam Workshop. I'd like to run the 156 a bit more on this route as well. Goes to me with that one, but I'm not going to get the problem. Lovely! LNER Apple Green, or ex-lner Apple Green. Of course, I don't think it ever actually held that paint scheme, but there are a couple of. There was a Hornby model, I think, made in that colour scheme. Steam generation rate is going up nicely. Hasn't yet exceeded the steam usage rate, but it will get there, I feel sure. Oh, they did use this scheme, says Bobby. Okay, I sit corrected. Six miles to our go via at Fort William Junction, and we are in a 70 still, so we can keep going. Boiler pressure's getting low. I'm gonna pull back on the power and get the boiler pressure to come back up a bit. It'll also give the fire mass time to catch up. While we're at it, let's chuck some water in. Do I have a cup of tea with me tonight? I have a cup of tea. I might have a cup of tea a little bit later on as well. Kev1185, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Water's coming up nicely. Boiler pressure is coming back now. Press the wrong button to start the firebox loading up and oopsie. Now we've got to try and catch up again. Hey there, couple of them out. Wow, this thing is just not gaining steam. Right, we're speeding up quite significantly now. We're going down another nasty hill. Holding the speed, I'm going to decelerate slightly, but that's fine. Struggling as we come down now, and we're only a couple of miles away from Fort William. Whoops. Apples and custard, I think you're quite right there, Moggy, that's quite appropriate. Right, going through the 60 limit, and we'll be into a 40. Abadello, no, it's one of the heritage ones. That's where it gets the creamsicle name from. I don't remember which one it is. I only briefly looked at the scenario. Thank you. Right, we're on a downhill slope again, so still in the 40 limit. Downhill, we've got a 60 limit coming up. We're on a 1 in 59 downhill at the moment. A green light, fantastic. Oh, the frame rate is real. Right, Fort William Junction approach is coming up, 3/4 of a mile away. Goodbye, OMG trains. Wow, it's half past 10 and we're already back under 100. That's three different types of signals we've had so far, out of three signals. Right, looks like Fort William's coming up on the HUD now. You're approaching the main junction at speed. Watch the signals carefully and have plenty of time to stop if you need to. I'm not really approaching it at speed though, let's be honest. Alright, we've got the warning for coming down to 50 and just under half a mile. Just yet. Oh wow, this is grinding. Right, this is 15. We're doing 15, so we're going a bit slow. I'm not sure I feel comfortable doing 60 on this. this bit of track. Hey there, Jack. What have you missed? What we're doing? 143 on Riviera line. Remember now is that point at the end of the platform must be set, otherwise you get a red light at the end of the platform, which is no use to anybody. Right, first instruction is to drop the coach door to do passengers now. And I'm being told my background is wrong, so let's fix the background. There you go. It's the only steam oil I've got. Right, use the task list to run around your train. Okay, so we are going to go to drop the coaches off first. And then we are going to pull forward to there. Oh, more Black 5 goodness. Right, stop there. And then we want to go back to approach over there. So we're going to need to change a couple of points, do the runaround maneuver, and then come back to the approach. Love that whistle. Oopsie. Mollisons. Gee, I wonder who that's supposed to be. Good evening, Dave. Clearly doing something in a downward direction that requires giving it force. Better. Now it's gonna roll properly. Who's this over here? Grand, sort of liberty. Right, we're just going to Fort William Station Approach, which is just round past this junction. Train level, not many scenarios. No, well, three is actually what I normally do try and do. I just usually fail abysmally and do more than that. So, but it's not many, but this is because, you know, this is an hour long and the next one's an hour and a half. Right, now we have to go back up to our coaches and front couple to them. Remember the days in MSTS where the phrase front couple brought shudders of fear and, oh no, is this going to crash? MSTS did not like front coupling. Right, press tab, the signal master will give you a shunt signal. Yes, he will. Request to pass signal danger approved. And the MSCS shuffle, absolutely moggy. What is the MSTS shuffle, says Dominus. Oh no. You're missing out on so much if you haven't been with the you haven't got the heritage in your blood. The MSTS shuffle was because it was a quirk of the way signalling worked in MSTS, in that sometimes you get stuck at a red signal, and the way to deal with being stuck at the red signal was to stop the train, go backwards and a foot, and then go forwards again, and when you change directions it recalculated what was going on, which meant that sometimes a green signal will miraculously turn not red. Anyway, sometimes you could, every time you stopped you had to do it. And then there was also sometimes they actually found they could use the MSTS shuffle to advantage by actually, because of the way signalling only worked up to reverse points, if you actually built two reverse points in, so you know, stop and go backwards then go immediately go forwards again, it would block the signals in front of the train, which means you'd get a red light. It would then allow it to allow another train to come in front of you and do the run, do it so you can do run-bys. So the player train could get looped. Is there any way you could reliably get the player train looped? Right, open your doors and let the passengers board again. Let's stop the train first, shall we? Right, now we can let the passengers on. Right away, put the white on the back. We've got a green light, that's always a good sign. Yeah, Ed, pretty much an MSTS shuffle was the way to get past almost every problem. How much longer was this scenario, Josh? We have got to go non-stop now. Well, don't crash. To Glenfinnan. I don't think it's that far away, actually. We'll find out. We've got 1 mile to Lockie East Distant, and then we'll get the information on the next waypoint. Green light. Very picturesque, isn't it, this? The flowers everywhere, very nice. What about the MSTS shovel? There actually wasn't such a thing. Right, we'll be out of this 16 and out of this 15 in a minute, and then we can speed up a little bit. Signal repeaters. Good. I love how packed in this route feels. Very claustrophobic, which is really good. Glenfinnan Viaduct, yes, that was the one used in the Harry Potter films. Another green signal. Thank you. remember down here because there's a crossing. Oh, can't sleep, too much caffeine. Yeah, that's bad news. See, we'll just welcome back. Watch for signals carefully. You may have to stop. Yeah, I think there's five. I think is the crossing for the bridge. So we just need to be a little bit careful. Fixed distance signal post. And then the light down here is always red on approach. That's the one. Because it marks the... It's all controlled as part of the big... there's two bridges down here. Sorry, there's two level crossings and a bridge, I think. And the swing bridge comes round. Acme Chief, the problem with the computer will be fixed at some point soon, hopefully. So what happens is as we approach this signal, so everything starts kicked into life to shut the level crossing gates and bring the bridge across. So if we approach it slow enough, it might go green before we even get there, if we're lucky. There you go, it's gone green. But we have got 5 mile per hour speed limit coming up as we go over the swing bridge. Do I still secretly wear the Pudsy onesie? I don't, but not for any good reason, it's really comfortable. This is the swing ridge just up here. So that sets us up for the 5 mile per hour limit. There's the other bridge. That quite, I think that one. Now that one doesn't work with the railway. That's separate. So, Jake, after the 24-hour stream, I imagine the Pudsy ones you can stand up its own. Yeah, pretty much. We'll just sit here and we'll watch the bridge to spin round because it's cool. Swing across in a minute. Scottish Ash, it's because the speed limit the train is has imposed upon it is based on the lowest speed limit any part of the train is in, and therefore if the any part of the train, as you come out of a 5 into a 40, you've still got bits of the train in the 5, and therefore those bits have to still obey a 5 mile per hour speed limit technically. Come on, bridge. There it goes. Oh, the road bridge does turn across. Isn't that cool? Oh, it was really cool actually. All the gates over there, all the stuff gets linked across. Good night, Steve. Boiler pressure's got low again. The real fan game. Was the pick ever put up on the office canteen wall? No. I didn't want to scare everybody. I've got 10 limit coming up. See what that looks like when it goes across. Looks like it's kind of precariously balancing up there, doesn't it? Got a fixed distance again, so I've probably got another signal coming up. I'm running slow because I'm trying to get the boiler pressure built back up. It's sort of struggling a bit. Limit now. There's your red light up there. It's a similar sort of a deal. I think this one's just protecting the level crossing. Right, the gates are down, it's time to go. Railfan game, I can't remember, it's one of the heritage liveries. Oh, we're back over, oh, we're over 100 again. Can we see the gates open? I think so. Let me just have a quick look ahead of this signal. Assuming I'm going the right way, obviously. Wow. Signal's I must have missed it. The gate's open yet? No. There you go. You saw the gate's open. Right. Train lover, yes, this is a J50. I'm about to get a bit of a downhill drop, so I'm just going to cut the power at this point and let it do that itself. Is this a Black 5? No, Big Four Truck Fans is not a Black 5. It's a wee green 7. Cheers, Amarillo. Still got a 40 limit, so we just maintain what we're doing. You're welcome, Francois. Slowing down, we just had a fixed distance. I don't know where the signal is, unless it's this one over here, but I'm going to err on the side of caution. Moggy's back with the fruit shoot. I presume you mean the fruit shoot lolly. Got a flashing blue, so we're good to carry on going. Ten miles to go. Speed limit here, 55. Right, let's get sped up then. Sped up a bit now. Doing okay on stats on the train, seems to be managing itself alright. What have we got? We're down to 9.5 miles. If we can keep up the section with the 55 limit, it won't take us too long to get some of this distance taken away. Boat or something. Right, we're up to the speed limit now. Better find out the speed limit's about to change. Nope, we're good. Francois, there is one video missing, part 20, I think it is. I don't think I'm going to be able to rescue that. It just will not upload to YouTube. It keeps failing. So, part 20 is missing. Apparently the speed limit is 40 here. 55 is for the LNERs. Train slow down then. We're slowing down slowly but surely. We're all the way up over here and we need to get to there. Yeah, and say they are, but the point is, the problem is with this one, it's you kind of got to turn around like that. It's particularly comfortable. Yeah, Dan, the sound of the wheels over the joints is very good. Cheers, Ron Wirral, thanks for joining. F comes to Scotland. Interesting, see Rogers. How are we doing? 5 miles to Glenfinnan. So put a bit more power on and get sped back up to the 40 limit. See you later, Fringe. See, Rogers, is this the standard one? Yeah, I don't think there is an advanced J50. Good night, Big Four Truck fan. Oops, slightly overfilled the firebox, I think. Right, 2.8 miles. Wow, crikey. Talk about people thinking this was a short show. We're going to be starting this. I think this has taken a bit longer than 60 minutes. Okay, as the standard and the advanced are different deliveries. Alright, see you, Rogers. I must admit I've not looked in detail. Long time since we published this one. I am a bit tired, actually. We've got a 30 limit coming up over the top of this hill. Oh, is that the bridge? Yep, Glenfinnan Viaduct. Right. Which means 3/4 of a mile, we're almost there. Carrying on our way back up, we're on 1 in 48 grade. How long will a full run take in a 156? I can't remember how long a full run takes. I think it's about 90 minutes for a full run. That's one of the challenges with running the scenarios, because there's very few of the scenarios that come with this pack I can run on the stream, because they're all quite long. Right, Glenfinnan platform is just up ahead. Yellow lights. Is that another Black 5? Stargate King, should yellow lights actually be called amber or does it matter? I believe I've been corrected, because I used to say amber, and I believe I've been corrected to say they're not amber, they're yellow. Because amber's orange and they're not orange, they're yellow. Right. What train we're driving, this is an LNER J50. It was by Mesh Tools, it's available on Steam. Lovely, lovely, lovely engine. Right, that's that one. Right, time to do the long scenario, it says, starting off after 11. Jeez. Really enjoyed that scenario. That scenario was Summer Seam started up by our kids in. Really nice, really nice. And thanks, Francois, for recommending that one. Very good.